And I can dance down the ramp. Keep coming
down.
Down
the ramp.
Workshop. Interesting, when we did the shadow dance, I said, all right, this is a great idea, now we'll get the performer in New York to do the shadow dance like this, but we discovered very quickly that it wasn't so simple just to show it and get someone to do it. So in that original first improvised shadow dance, both was used in the production, in the projections at the Met, and it's also one of the screens in the installation in the exhibition here. And a lot of the material that is in the installation comes from the production. There's a lot of extra material too. And it's never quite certain. It's important that I never quite know, is the work done on the exhibition here a preparation for what's going to be seen at the Metropolitan Opera House? Or in fact, and more I think, this whole complicated, enormous process of making the opera is a very recondite, elaborate way of arriving at the material that exists in the installation as it's finally shown, because the production itself has 7 performances, and that's it. And the installation has different lives, different shapes. It's shown in the space like the gallery here. It's shown in much larger spaces in other institutions. It expands and contracts, but continues with its own life. Then, to come from this to... These are some of the first, just some stills. I'll show you some stills of the first thinking about costumes, and then some photographs of the actual production of the final opera. And one of the ways about thinking of the opera and what it is to be directing a whole opera is to think about a drawing at an enormous scale. There's a way in which there's a drawing the size one does it, say the size of this book, and then as soon as it's filmed, it has the possibility of expansion through projection, either to the size of the screen here, or to the size we show in the exhibition, or in the case of the Opera House, to the full size of the proscenium, 5 stories high and very wide that one can do the projection. And there's a tapestry on exhibition, which is a similar kind of thing. There's a way in which a tapestry is like a projection. It's like a digital projection, because that is also made up of these lines and grids and these pixels that make up a projection, in the same way that a tapestry has all the lines of the warp and the weft and a decision at every cross line of the thread. So a tapestry is another way of fixing a projection, of making a projection that can be no longer ephemeral. But to first see some of the process of the costume designs. So they start very loosely with collages and ideas, both from myself and from the costume designer. And then these small maquette figures are the figures, the scale of the model that we make of the stage. And then I'll show you some of the photographs of the So this is the stage itself at the Met, where you can see the fragments from the first workshop of some of the costumes make their way in. It's a scale in which one, it's a mixture of performance in front of projections and large-scale projections behind. Some of those projections you'll see on the exhibition here. Okay. So the scale of the piece when it finally reaches the opera house is kind of the maximum expansion of the world of the studio back out into the world. But generally speaking, the work itself always happens through the process of picking things off the wall at different places, allowing different things come together, in a way inviting the world into the studio, letting the studio be a place where the world is deconstructed and fragmented and shattered, and then reconstructed in some new form, and then sent back out into a gallery, onto a wall, into a theater. And it strikes me that when I was talking about this walking around the studio and what it meant to have all those objects around it, that the studio becomes a demonstration or a metaphor for our head. It's as if your head has expanded to the size of the edges of this room. And instead of thoughts having this 3-centimeter journey of from one synapse or through the synapses from one section to another, that journey is, as it were, made visible in your walk across the studio, picking something up, taking something other. But that the process, which one thinks of as very much the process of an artist working in the studio, is in fact simply a physical demonstration of what we all do all the time, taking a million different possible fragments that bombard us, things we remember, things we've read, something's just told us, a phone call we're having, something we're seeing in the distance, where we are in the middle of a novel, putting that together with the TV series that we're watching. And through this, we nonetheless, from this collage, through a collage, construct a semblance of coherence. And very often we think of it as normal and coherent, and this is what the truth is, or this is what the fact is. Rather than understanding at all stages, it's an astonishing construction that is being made the whole time. And when you think of it as in terms of looking at an artwork, it's very clear. One is aware of an image coming towards you, of an image that is presented, and you looking at the image and making sense of it. That the image is a membrane between the world and yourself, and that its completion has to do always not just with what the image is. It's not as if we're a blank receptor. All our previous knowledge, all our knowledge of other images, of other things we've thought or remembered or been told about, come in and construct the final coherence or incoherence we give to the object. And it seems to me that what the artist does emblematically is make this naturalist process, which gets hidden, very visible, both to make us aware of two things. Firstly, of agency, the agency we have in the world to make meaning, that we all have it. Artists do it as their job, but it's only a demonstration of what we all do, whether we like it or not. We complete things when we don't hear something that someone has said, we fill in the missing word. We don't understand the connection between two fragments of an image. We act as if it could possibly mean something else. So agency is the one thing that I think the activity in the studio can be used to demonstrate. And the second thing that is also demonstrated, I think, is the provisionality of all opinion, thought, and fact. That when someone says, when they look at a work, it is this, the film is this, it is boring, rather than saying, between the film coming towards me and me watching the film, what I received back was a disconnect. And understanding always in every moment of certainty can only be asserted by raising your voice or having someone standing next to you with a big stick. But otherwise, all views and understandings and comprehensions are provisional and very much determined by the mixture of the world coming towards you and you meeting it. And I think that's what the experience of being in the studio and understanding how the works come together has led me to. And so a lot of the work that's done now is a further exploration or demonstration of it. But I think at this stage, I'm happy to take some questions, and I'm sure other images will come into play from that. Sorry? I can keep showing more things. I must keep showing more things. Well, okay, we do a deal. You ask me a question, I show you a new thing. Otherwise, it's... Yes, a question here. Okay. Why is my exhibition called Poems I Used to Know? There's a sense of... I think that, firstly, the title doesn't relate directly to the works on. There's a large drawing which has that phrase in it. But it has to do with a lost certainty, something you used to know, you think clearly, and now you have to push your mind to get a glimpse of it. It's where when you see something that tantalizes you towards something else. So that's the hope, that the work on the exhibition is not just seen as what it is, but is something that can spark other thoughts and other memories. I mean, this is me making it up as I'm speaking about what the title of the exhibition or why it's there. The bulk of the exhibition is the one work called I Am Not Me, The Horse Is Not Mine. And that phrase, I Am Not Me, The Horse Is Not Mine, is a phrase that was used by Bukharin in the show trials. And it's an old Russian peasant phrase saying, I'm innocent, I'm not guilty. I'm not me, the horse is not mine, I didn't do it. So that's the other part. All right, I'll show you. One of the pieces of work that I have on the exhibition is a triptych of three flipbooks. Now, you know flipbooks where you flip a little book and you see someone playing a cricket stroke or a simple action that you can see once as you flip it. And this is an ongoing project. I'm in the middle of the project now. The three films is one film, and there are other films being made. And it takes the idea of a flipbook, of different drawings on different pages of a book, and expands it. So instead of just one flip over 3 seconds, there are many drawings on many pages, and these get filmed and projected, but as a kind of proto-flipbook. And this is both the idea of an image in a book, so all the pages like ideas in one's head, thousands of ideas in your head, the way the pages turn. It's also about being trapped, a book as a kind of prison, the prisoner in the book. You can never escape the covers of the book as he walks backwards and forwards. But one of the things I'm going to show you, the films on the exhibition are done without a sound. There's a minimal sound of a projector turning. But I've also been using them as a way of thinking about different sound and images. And so the film I'll show you now is one of the flipbooks, but which a tango has been added to. And in fact, we used it in a performance piece that's we've been showing recently, and it's one of 20 chapters of the performance piece, and there's a dancer in front of the projection when it's done there. But let me find it here.
Thank you. sia bella. Il Sicotti sia bella. Sicotti sia bella. Oh, 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 oh. Sicotti, Sicotti,
Sicotti sia. And sing and do, and sing and do, and sing and do. Ah.
Sicotti, Sicotti, Sicotti sia bella. Scotty sia bella. Is it good? Is it good?
And do and sit and do. Is it good? And sit and do.
Is it
good?
Is it good? Sia bella. Is it good? Sia bella. Is good?
Okay, that gives you enough of the sense of it as it goes on. But here also I'll show you one more. Here we go. One more of these flip books, again, which it's not on the exhibition, it was a test. This is what you're seeing, is a kind of a test to see about these pages turning together with a voice. There's a project I'll be working on with the Schubert song cycle, and I haven't got the Schubert with this, but thinking about the song cycle with this kind of image. It's interesting, afterwards maybe I'll show you the tango film and we can see if I can find some Schubert on the computer to put the two together, so you see the same film with a very different kind of music. But this is a set of sonnets, the most predictable sonnets, I'm afraid.
Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Thou art more lovely and more temperate. Rough winds do shake the darling buds of May, and summer's lease hath all too short a date. Sometimes too hot the eye of heaven shines, and often is his gold complexion dimmed, and every fair from fair some time declines, by chance or nature's changing course, untrimmed. But thy eternal summer shall not fade, nor lose possession of that fair thou owest, nor shall death brag thou wanderest in his shade, when in eternal lines to time thou growest. So long as men can breathe or eyes can see, so long lives this, and this gives life to thee.
Okay, so that was looking at it. We can look at it now. We can try it with the Schubert and see if it is of any interest. I mean, this I have not tried with this flipbook. Just takes a moment to get the different parts of the piece together.
Ich will den Boden küssen, ich will meine
So, not so much, but interested always to see what the different music does to what one sees. Maybe we try it with the tango. Let's see if it's better with the tango. Must be a faster way of doing it, but I don't.